everyone.
All right, Larry, thanks. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to Gillette Stadium in Foxborough, Mass. Coming up, it's Divisional Round Saturday. We've got an AFC battle on tap between the Buffalo Bills and the New England Patriots.
Series, who's going to gain an advantage? Well, we saw exactly what happened there. The tone was definitely set by the offensive team.
Now, Deion Lewis returns. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line.
Let's go! Green!
actually just praying, and I'm not quite sure of his answer.
Now Hoyer. This pass caught at the four. And the stop will come inside the five at the four. A gain of seven that time. Second goal. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage.
Who they are, but on third and short, that's really when you put it out there and tell people who you are, and that's exactly what they did. For the offense, they're looking at their offensive line and saying, guys, where are you? We need you on those plays.
And the 11-year veteran has a goal, and they're going to lay back down four now at 14-10. So the drive takes him inside the 10, but it ends with just three.
And a nice job defensively to rise up and make sure they didn't get in.
Chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Bills getting set to go. This is their third drive. Right now, maybe not about points, just about getting something. They haven't gotten a first down yet in this game.
It's a mental barrier you don't think about until you go a couple of drives without getting a first down. And all of a sudden, it looms big. You get tired of it, got your team that first down.
And this one complete to Zane Jones. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. A gain of 6 there on first. I think defensively, you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on. And I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that, you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch. Now you put the offense in a position where every series, they have to work hard to pick up first down.
With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Second quarter about to get underway with the Bills in possession. And they've got it here with a first down. See, as a big boy coming up there and swallow you whole in those D tackles and those tackles.
No, you're actually counting on your big boys to protect you from this. Put on that play. The defensive tackle had the leverage.
Big tight end Clay for the Buffalo first.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to. Pick up a first down.
Just what you want on a first down run. Called 8 yards, and it's second and 2.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down, and as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
Off the play fake, here's Taylor. Paid this week in practice to red zone offense. The coach was optimistic about how it went. We'll see. From the red zone now, here's Taylor. And now escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Second down, Taylor. Now the right side, it's the Taylor. possession. And Hauschka's kick is good. And that moves him up by a touchdown now at 17-10. So a 15-play drive. Can't believe that only resulted in three, but it did.
That is somewhat amazing, isn't it? When you hold the ball that long, run offense that well, yet only put 3 points on the board,
God,
this could be a little bit of a disappointment, doesn't it?
Has to.
Let's go!
They go play action here on first down. Sliding out of the pocket. Nice work to get seven out of that, and it's second down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
1:59 to go in the first half.
Watch it now, Barney! Barney!
A reminder, as we did all through the regular season, we'll check in with Larry Ridley at halftime. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half.
Pressure forced his eyes down to see the rush. It was time to make a break for it.
Remaining in half number one.
Come on!
10 yards. Good enough for a Buffalo first down.
Here at the EA Sports Studio. We'll get you back out to the field now for some more playoff action.
Set to return. This is Brandon Cooks. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the...
Change up anything on this opening drive?
Not offensively, you don't. You got everything going your way. You're probably prepared for maybe some changeups you might expect, but overall, you like what your game plan showing you.
Clock's running down. Play clock down to zero. And this is not the way to start a drive.
Delay of game, offense.
They were trying to create some space to run. They created the penalty.
And you work on it so much. You work on it so hard.
It's tough to simulate game speed in practice. That often runs you into a penalty.
Back it up. Watch it now, Barney. Barney, let's go. 3-19. 3-19.
He's going to flip that out here to his running back. It's a gain of 9 yards. And that'll make it second down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware the ball may come your way.
6 yards to go here on second down.
Hurry up,
Connor!
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Here's Hoyer.
So the corner route is usually a great spot to get it down.
Now Hoyer. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. So he can't hang on. And as I watch that unfold, I remember the expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know, but you're going to get hit anyways. Might as well hold on to the ball.
Well, you know, it comes from that, right? Not actually. Not having a chance at all. Way easier said than done.
Gronkowski, the intended target, and it's third down.
But they're slinging it. And then there's one you got to put a timer on, huh?
Detroit!
I mean, that one came in.
All right, here we go.
Came off and overthrown out of his reach and incomplete. Another one thrown incomplete.
That's a first down if he holds on, but you saw the contact. Able to jar it free from him and force a fourth down.
Great play defensively there, as you said, just to knock it free. Because if he had caught that, pass the sticks, first down. And Gostkowski's kick is good. And with that, they take the lead here, 20-17. So it goes down as an 8-play drive, and they cap it with the field goal.
Yeah, they were able to pick up a few first downs along the way, but they couldn't keep the momentum going all the way into the end zone.
To the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here.
Trying to get things kick-started for them. And you know they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where sprinting comes into play a lot of the time.
Please do script coming out of the second half.
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12-16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8-10. Kind of a starter or whatever they were.
First. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Sometimes you look at a quarterback. When the quarterback starts to struggle, who goes over and picks him up?
Yeah, that's always a big one, isn't it? Usually, there's a quarterback whisper or something. There's an assistant coach. There's one of his best friends on the team.
Patrick,
get with him and say, all right, my man, what do you need? What's going on here? So there's one person he can lean on. He's got to lean on that guy right now.
And that left side is Gronkowski. And this time, not quite to the 30. He'll be down. 41-yard line.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can get some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Hoyer, on the left side of the pitch by Rose. It's a 7-yard gain there. It's good enough to move the chains.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, to let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
He gets it into the hands of Gronkowski, complete. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 and the 16-yard line. A good pickup there.
Patriot.
Seeing that play and understand just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that.
Great job. It's tough to turn those upfield and go, but he did a great job with it there.
Really good balance, really good body control, and how about the end result? A touchdown. Mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him. Back now in Foxborough. The Bills have the football, but they trail here as we begin quarter number four.
Come on, let's go!
Now Taylor on first down. Nothing on that one. It'll be second down. Here comes play number six on this drive.
Here we go! One, nine, one, one.
So the offense, a little antsy, the flag comes out. And a 5-yard penalty.
False start, offense.
And that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves it back 5. The Bills on third down. They've hit 4 of 7. This is 3rd and 9.
Let's go! 1, 9, 5!
After the penalty, it's McCoy. And they get to him quickly as he stopped right around the 13. Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a 4th down. So on 4th down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. His kick is good, and the drive will wind up yielding 3. All right, so you needed 2 scores to get back in the game. The field goal then maybe not exactly what they wanted, but it's a necessary first step.
Still plenty of time remaining, but you could really use a stop defensively after the kickoff, preferably a 3 and out.
Now the Patriot offense set to take over again, and they'll be looking to build off of a nice drive last time, a drive that really relied on the quarterback.
Making good decisions, distributing the ball well, distributing it.
And he goes down outside of the pocket for a sack. Trying to get away, but could not. Jerry Hughes in there to pick up his 2nd sack now of the afternoon.
Was it a breakdown in protection? Did the running back not pick him up? What does it really matter? Sometimes it's just a great play made by the defense. Big time sack.
To the 29-yard line, brought down there. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a 3rd down. Shake the thoughts of that interception on the last drive. You come out and start this one 4th and 4.
Imagine if they're around with that type of confidence.
Then
you gotta to where the screen guy is. And of course, the blocking has to form in front to get him downfield for the touchdown.
Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. Now the Bills offense gets ready to head back onto the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They run 2 plays and they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But also have to remember they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
Out there, and I know that they've double teamed him a couple times, but not a ton. But what they're doing is working. He's up over 100 yards. We'll see how they adjust.
And when they do that, they weaken their defense in other places as well. How many times have we done games where we've seen a big game like this? It's usually not by himself, is it? But usually it opens it up for other people to have big games as well.
To book a trip to the AFC title game. And his kick here is good. And it's celebration time on that sideline as they have taken the lead in the final seconds. Well, sometimes you get a mismatch in these divisional round games. Not here. This has been everything we could have hoped for.
Okay, Brandon, don't get mad at me, but it's time for the old cliche.
Bring it.
Neither of these teams deserves to lose, but in the end, it's looking like the late field goal is going to be the difference in this game.
That's a good cliche. We'll let that one go.
When you're facing a deficit on the scoreboard, you're just looking for something to get you right back into the game, and that's the spark that they were looking for. They got it with that big return.
Let's go! Brian 38!
One last shot for Taylor. He's going to let it fall. Oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. T-shirts and hats ready, my friend?
They have to, Brandon. They have to be ready because if you win, you've got to hand those out on the field right away. And just think about the pressure for the players now. Family's going to be talking about tickets to the Super Bowl even before you play the conference championship game.
The players on your team quickly upgrade your team at the end of each game. You have an injury from the last game. See how long they will be out.
Oh.